everybody, welcome to the second episode of Nightshade's Recommendations. Once again, we're going to be talking about an author and a book series. Well, not quite a book series. It's a book series and two of his spin-offs. Ignore the mess around here. Ignore the messiness. the author I want to talk to you about is called Jack Campbell. He's called Jack Campbell, although that is a, if I'm right, it is a bit of a pseudonym. His name isn't actually Jack Campbell. It is, where is it? Ooh, I've lost it. Trying to find it. Yes, that's right. His name is John Henry, but he goes by the name of Jack Campbell for his books. The first one is his first series is called The Lost Fleet, and the first one is called Dauntless. So that's it there. It's basically about this war that has been going on for about 100 years, and it's about this. Is this war that's going to begin off between the Alliance, the humans, and the Syndicates, also humans. So it's two humans, war, and all that stuff. Yes. I should tell you before, that is going to be slight spoilery stuff, because I'll be talking about the two spin-offs as well, you see. But yes, and basically, at the beginning of a book, this war's been going on for about a century, and Just before the book actually starts, in the timeline of the series, a man who's presumed dead from the very beginning of the war, called Captain Black Jack Geary, is discovered. He's not dead. They all thought he was dead, but he's not dead, and he basically is given the task of saving this fleet that is lost in the middle of Syndicate space. And he's given this mission, and it's a fantastic series. Absolutely brilliant. He really is. Him, along with Mike Cole from my last episode, is probably my favourite authors at the moment. I absolutely adore this series. The one criticism I might have is because while I do at times constructive criticism time and all that stuff. I love his books. I do love his books because of the politics that happen between the space battles. I mean, there's so much politics. I'm trying to think what I could say without spoiling it for you, because I really do recommend you go and read these books. They're fantastic. And yes, so we've got. But the thing that I probably don't like, I'm not the biggest fan of, is the space battles. I find them a little bit dull. But they are more than made up for by the characters. The characters are written in such a way that they are absolutely, you feel for them. You get attached to them. You begin to hate some of them. You begin to care for a lot of them. And when, inevitably, as it happens in books, some of them leave through no fault of their own, you feel sadness. You feel for the characters in this book and in this series. And it's just, I adore it so much. I adore it. And then, so this series is a 6-book series, beginning with Dauntless and ending with Victorious. He then has also got he's got two spin-offs. The two spin-offs do take place in the Lost Fleet universe. And the first spin-off I want to talk to you about is called The Lost Fleet Beyond the Frontier. Now, this is where you get a little bit, I can't help but give you a bit of spoilerificness here. I am going to warn you that there are going to be spoilers, a little bit of spoilers. But yeah, so the first one is called Guardian. No, it's not. It's called Dreadnought. Sorry, I was looking up one of the ones down there, down here, and it's got Guardian down there. Yes, there's three at the moment. The latest one being Guardian. Sorry about that. but yes, Dreadnought. It's called Beyond the Frontier. Because, and it's basically beyond... Because basically you've got the Alliance space, the Syndicate space, and then there's this stuff here. This is the frontier here. The edge of Syndicate space. On the other side, away from the Alliance. That's the frontier. And this is about what's beyond the frontier. And beyond the frontier. And in this one... Oh, I'm gonna have to do spoiler here. There is a spoiler, so be careful. Aliens. They discover aliens, and that's why they go beyond the frontier, to map out the alien territories. And this is fantastic. I'm really looking forward to where he takes this series, because this series isn't finished yet. He's got another three, I think he said. I think he told me, because I emailed him, and just basically to basically splurge about how great these books are and how much I love his books. And I think if I remember correctly, he told me about there was another three planned. Where he goes from there, I don't know. But I do hope he continues, at least continues with this universe, because this universe is brilliant. I love this universe. It's fantastic. Once again, this time, not so much the politics, because there's still a lot of politics, because it turns out that the Alliance doesn't trust the Navy, the ships, the military, everything. And but so there's still politics, everything, and I love the meetings that Gary, because Gary's still in these, Gary's still a main character in this series. I love the meetings that he has with the Alliance members, because they're just fantastic, because he comes from a time when he's dedicated completely to the Alliance. He doesn't care about, you know, his own aspirations, his own ambitions. His job is purely to serve the Alliance, to serve the people. But that's not the world he's in now. The world is much different now. The world is, there's a lot of politicalness and backstabbing and ambitiousness. And Gary's whole attitude upsets everybody, because they don't know how to handle it. They don't know how to deal with this person. They know how to deal with the military from their time, because they've had years and years of dealing with it. They know how to handle it. They don't know how to handle this different mindset. Which brings me nice and neatly to the second of his spin-offs. Called The Lost Stars. First one is called Tarnished Knights. And the second one is called Perilous Shield. He's only got two out of the moment, but he's got more planned, which is good. And these are an interesting one. These goes completely in a different vein from the Lost Fleet, Beyond the Frontier, and the normal Lost Fleet series, because these are from the perspective of the Syndicates. And they overlap with the Beyond the Frontier books, because they're set at the same time as Beyond the Frontier. And it's really interesting, because even though that they're the Syndicates, and the Syndicates are bad, they are they're very business-minded, while the Alliance may have things like generals and admirals and so forth. The Syndicates have CEOs and line workers and things like that, and it's really interesting to see how Jack Campbell has gone into the mindset of these people. And going back to the whole Alliance leaders not being able to handle John Geary's mindset, it's even more extreme with when Gary deals with the Syndicates in these books, because even more so than the Alliance, the Syndicates are all about having plans behind plans behind plans, manipulating events and everything. And so when they're talking with Gary, and they're thinking, Right, he's saying these things, but he must have other plans behind it. And we know that's not what Geary's about. Geary doesn't do that sort of stuff. He is basically what you see is what you get with him. What you hear is what you get. There's no plans behind him, behind those plans. He doesn't have second meanings. He really is just all about what's right for him, morally. He doesn't have any other plans and everything. And that's just, it's really interesting because they're like saying, well, he's got these other plans, blah, 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 blah. He must have other plans. And you're just reading and thinking, he doesn't, he doesn't. You're wrong. And another really, really, really good series. Wow, I'm actually looking at the time here. I'm talking less. It's going to be shorter than my other one, which was only three books. Interesting. But yes, I'm trying really desperately not to spoil it because it's such a fantastic series. I like it. I think I probably enjoy these series and this author more than Mike Cole's Shadow Ops series. I absolutely adore. I'm going to put links to his website down below for you. So I really do recommend that you buy these books and you give them a go. I know I've already managed to convince one of my friends to give Dauntless a go. I kept on bugging him to buy it when I was in Waterstones with him. And he said, fine, I will buy it, I will trust you. But this. I'm trying to think what else I can say now because I've just gushed and gushed about it. Like I say, the actual space battles do tend to get a little dull at times, and I do find myself a little bit bored by them. But they are just they. The rest of the series, the characters, the setting, the politics behind it all, that's what makes the books for me. That's what makes the series for me. And yes, the characters are fantastic. Like I say, the characters in the Lost Fleet, and those characters are then obviously carried onwards into the Beyond the Frontier spin-off series. But even the Lost Stars one with Lost Stars spin-off with the syndicates, even then they've got you get the characters who you feel for, you want them to succeed in their mission, what they're planning on doing. You feel for them, and their thing. Oh, what's the right word for it? Their interactions are at times better than the Alliance ones in the Lost Fleet and Beyond the Frontier. It's a series. I absolutely adore these series, and if they ever do end, I will be most sad. But yes, so I'm gonna draw this to a close now because I've just sort of gushed and gushed and gushed and done bugger all really. Other than say, buy these books, they're fantastic, and here are why. But yes, please do go out and buy them. I'll put a Amazon link to the first one, Dauntless, as well down in the thing below. He doesn't have Twitter, so I can't unfortunately link you to his Twitter page. I'm not sure. I think he might have a Facebook page, in which case I'll link you to that as well down here, down there. But I'm not 100% sure whether he has or not. But yes. So please do go and buy it. Next episode, I think I'll try a TV series. I'll recommend a TV series for you all. But until then, go and buy books.